Where is it? Okay, Gulf News, August 12th, 2021. This is Gulf News. The title says, Abu Dhabi's NMC Healthcare set to say final goodbye to B.R. Shetty's legacy on September 1. So September 1 onwards, B.R. Shetty will be erased. The current management of NMC's healthcare, the new management, UAE's biggest privately owned hospital, will not be distracted with what its founder B.R. Shetty is doing. In other words, B.R. Shetty, fuck you. What you're doing in US, what you're doing anywhere, you can't touch us, you can't impact us, you can't influence us. You're trying to show your power. Fuck you. We will show you our power. This is what it means, indirectly. We will show you who we are. Okay? And you can't touch us. Basically, that's what it means, indirectly. Even when he has filed a 7 billion plus compensation claim in New York court, alleging he was a victim of financial fraud carried out by former management of NMC working with the cortege of banks and officials, it's not clear why Shetty, based in the South Indian state of Karnataka, for more than a year now, filed compensation for a US court. In other words, see, this is a very diplomatic way of saying. In other words, they are laughing at B.R. Shetty. What a fucking truth. Here, yele, muh mein dal, means put it in your fucking mouth. Your property is in UAE, your money is in UAE, your business in UAE, you're going to US, you think we'll be afraid? You think we'll be scared because you went to US? Take it in your mouth. Put my balls on your, you know, inside your, suck on them. So, because what they're trying to say is, what grounds do you have? What grounds do you have? So even though they have made a, he has made a filing, they're saying, make a filing. We are dissolving everything. So spend money, go to a lawyer. We are selling off everything. Who will you take to court? Old management, after we have sold off, we'll take the Sheikh to court, we'll take UAE to court. Okay, nor is it known whether Shetty intends to fly back to the UAE now that flight services have resumed. This is a fucking slap on Shetty. It's a fucking slap. What they are trying to say is, flights have resumed. Come. Come, man. You got balls. Come, come. Show me your balls. Come down, fly. Do you have anything? Come, open challenge. Come now, fly. We know, I know, you know. He's just going to put in the news. Oh, I tried to fly from Delhi. They stopped me. Oh, I tried to fly from Karnataka. They stopped me. If Carlos Ghosn could escape in a, you know, in a box, you think B.R. Shetty can't fly from India? Vijay Mallya can run away. You know that cricketing guy who created IPL. What is that? Manoj, no? Can't get his name. If he can run out of India, B.R. Shetty can't? Come on, man. You know, I know. This is fucking bullshit. Now these sellers for the fruits. You'll hear their noise. Don't mind. Okay. But none of this matters to NMC Health and the executives at Alvarez and Marshall, the consultancy that is overseeing the hospital's operator. Wait, let these guys go, man. It's so fucking irritating. I don't hate them, but I just want them to go. So, others, you'll be hearing me and them talk and nothing makes sense. Okay. But none of this matters to NMC Health and executives at Alvarez and Marshall. But none of this matters. In other words, B.R. Shetty, you dance like a monkey, man. None of it matters. The consultancy that has been overseeing the hotel's operator returned to full financial health. That means, again, see where they are prodding him. That means we will bring it back to full financial health. Means you fucked it up. Or somewhere close to it. Somewhere close to it means we'll try our best. If we fail, don't bloody put an article, an interview. See, they destroyed NMC. What the UAE government and UAE will say is, we tried to bring it back to full financial health, but B.R. Shetty had destroyed it so badly, we couldn't save it. The patient was too sick. I like this article, very intelligently written, huh? By the way, very nice. It's like double-sided meaning. We don't see that cutting across what we do here, said Benjamin K. Cairns of A&M, responding to whether Shetty's filing a case in New York will have any bearing on NMC's immediate plans and future. In the bracket, A&M was appointed by a UK court to take on the task of restructuring NMC after evidence of billions of dollars of bank loan being diverted from the company's coffers came to light last year. So here also they're putting a nice sentence telling you, see, this is not UAE. We didn't appoint. It's a UK court. You know, I know. You pay money. You can get someone to appoint someone from some other country. Let's not act dumb. Okay. Anyway, banking industry sources means anyone can be a source. How do you know which source? So I can just put the sources. My sources told me. That's why people always say, Lloyd, don't fucking make us a fool. You just got your information from thin air. So just as people don't buy, some people don't buy or believe, which you should not. I totally respect. So banking sources, some source. Where is it? Okay, banking sources who have been tracking NMC Shetty's situation since December 2019 echo these statements. We don't know any name. We don't know which bank, but some banking sources. Shetty in deciding NMC's future is non-existent. That means you are a nothing and nobody to NMC. Okay. According to them, the future of NMC will be decided in the UAE that the recovering of billions owned to banks is far more important than Shetty's claims. In other words, Shetty, you're no longer important. Your requirements, your claims are no longer important. What you need, in fact, you are irrelevant. We are giving more priority to others. Okay, and obviously when you say that we have to give priority to people who owe money, nobody will say that they are wrong. Change of ownership, NMC's next important date is September 1, and the process to change ownership structure will get going. Actually, it's already done. Everyone knows by default, Saudi, UAE, it's like vultures being there waiting for the lion to die. As soon as he dies, they jump on it and eat it, you know, ripping it to shreds like hyenas. You're just waiting for that creature to die. It's the same way. This will mean the creditors of NMC will formally assume ownership of the entity. Whomsoever has to be paid money will be taking ownership. And you see here, this one is a kind of gray statement. What does it mean? What do I mean by that? You can say banks have to be paid first. But then if I have signed up as the owner of the company and I have said, oh, these billions are owned to me, who can challenge it? See, there are many ways to play these games. Just as B.R. Shetty claimed that Ernst & Young manipulated the books of accounts. We have, Enron. You saw, remember the collapse of Enron. And Anderson, what? Arthur Anderson. Hope I got that name right. See, there are so many financial firms that can play with the books of accounts. Yes. What you want? Now she says, what you want? What you want? My daughter. Okay. So just as they can play with the books of accounts and... Yeah, see, basic thing, remember, where law is concerned, the courts and lawyers. If you can make O.J. Simpson innocent, if you can make Bill Cosby innocent because there are loopholes in the law, you think they can't play some funny game through the books of law, change the language? So anyway, I feel that banks will be paid. Means the big ones, they will sign up with them and say, listen, if you have to pay you 100 million, you want, we'll pay you now. Say yes to 30 million and take the other as write-off. Others will make you wait for 10 years. So banks will say, okay, fine, let's cut down our losses. They will definitely sit down and eke out a deal. I know how it works. Because I've spoken to people who have to, even those who have to pay credit cards, when they tell them, see, listen, I want to pay it back. I owe you 100,000. Let's negotiate. Stop this interest rate and all this shit. I'll pay lump sum. They negotiate. So negotiation is always there. This means the creditors of NMC will formally assume ownership of the entity, winding down the rule by the administrators. The creditors will decide a future course of action and process, and the process it will take means you'll not be able to find out who's in charge, who's making the decision, what's happening. But the end result is you have lost everything and fuck you. You can't do anything to us. Based on the current plans, they will oversee an NMC sale to a new buyer. It's already, you remember they said we sold for $1, which will inject much needed funds in the organization. The process ideally could take further 2 or 3 years. Hence, BHRT, we are waiting for you to die. You are anyway nearly 80 years old. So it might take 2, 3 years, 5 years, 10 years. You keep going to USA and filing. For the September 1st meeting, a simple majority among creditors will be enough. Get the new ownership structure approved, said a source. The people on the board, who, in other words, what they're saying is, in other words, the people of the board whom we appointed, all who will dance to our tunes, all who will say what we want them to say, we have already agreed that they will say yes, but out of formality, we will just have a meeting and then we'll announce the answer, which anyway people, by the way, the salaries of NMC employees or all these other Finabler and all that, I don't think it's going to be paid. This is my challenge, take it as bad debts. Why I'm saying this, because I know so many people who get in touch with the law, will I get paid the salary, 3 months, 4 months, 6 months, not paid, gratuity not paid. I just tell them it's too late, man. So, okay, then, this is vital. While A&M have carried all the support of all the creditors, there is one significant holdout. Dubai Islamic Bank is another creditor and has taken the matter of loan recovery on its own. The bank has legal cases going on in local court and they have scored a significant win recently. In other words, UAE will say, our banks, our country, our creditors, the new partners, we will get paid first, then the other people. So everything UAE first. Which anyway is predicted because it's UAE, the business is in UAE, so law of the land. Then, even if DIB declines approval by September 1st, ownership change plans, NMC and ARM officials assure they have enough votes to take them to the next step. In other words, listen, Dubai Islamic Bank, we are supposed to be 100 million, be happy with 20 million. Others, fuck you. We will delay it for 10-20 years. Once a majority vote was confirmed, it will take a further 3 to 5 months for the approval of ownership transfers to be effected. If this timetable holds good, by January of 2022, means August, September, October, November, December, okay, within 4 to 5 months, NMC Healthcare will have migrated to full change of ownership for the first time since VR Shetty founded the company in 1970s. So saddening. A man who created this brand that was his baby has to let go of everything. Okay, now in Saudi, one of them would like to sell NMC's joint venture in Saudi Arabia. We are in close discussion with interested parties at Karen's. Of course, who doesn't want a piece of the pie? NMC said identified a strategy where the focus exclusively on UAE Oman operations and put all other interests on sale. Have you noticed no mention of Saudi because of the tensions? Well, anyway, but money is money, so they wouldn't mind. Apart from Saudi's interest in UK-based Aspen, a private operator there, but it will also be sold in due course. Everything will be sold, finished, bits and pieces, like I told you. Dying lion, vulture and hyenas. They are all waiting to take their piece by piece. Operationally strong, little bit of PR to show that, listen, we got a good asset, who wants to buy? On its core operations, providing healthcare support in UAE, NMC was getting its numbers right. Of course, can manipulate these numbers. Whether that is handling COVID-19 related treatments, needs, or handling the most active maternity ward across the hospitals, NMC is making its presence count. Yes. The hospitals in UAE are only interested in money. The more sick you are, the better it is for them. The more they make you dependent on them, the more money. It's a business, no? So please stay sick. One of my biggest priorities is to continue to push towards a better operational efficiency and improve our business clinical process across the organization. This is all bullshit which CEOs give. Michael Davis, CEO, yeah, of course, he has to say all this. This is a typical, I mean, if you listen to any CEO, they'll say, oh, improve process, organizational efficiency. You can just copy paste from the internet and give some bullshit and people will believe. Because we need to continue to deliver strong performance, we see in the first quarter of 2021 and keep the shareholders happy. I'm giving the extra from my side. Keep the shareholders happy, diversify, bootstrap operations, cut down this thing, motivate our staff, unify loose ends, and we have a strong culture with the values and our vision, mission and goal and all that. Lauda Lasund, my ball sack is brown. No way. Okay, I personally look forward to working with the new ownership structure and deliver as much as possible, much value as possible, and can to those people who have supported us during a very difficult time for the organization. I don't know who is this clown, who is the CEO. But anyway, nice bullshit statements written by somebody. Told his secretary, write some nice sounding words and just send it. Finish. I just want my salary. I want my payday. I want my compensation. And after it's done, I'll resign. And I'll go relax on my yacht in some island. That's the life of a CEO. You work your entire life just for this payday and then retire. On September 1st, the process of transition takes a huge leap forward, irrespective of what plays out in the court in New York. In other words, Shetty, Yele, Mera Bosra. I don't know much of Hindi, but anyway. Yeah, put my hairy, salty, brown, hairy nutsack on your head and dance. Nothing you'll do will happen. Go to New York, spend all the money, make a court case. Here we'll dissolve your company. And then you can sit in New York and hope from, you know, the second blessed, Immaculate Conception got pregnant without a baby. Without a dick. That's nice, no? You can make someone pregnant with whoosh, and three wise men will come. Star will also whoosh, show. Magic show. Anyway, this is what my analysis of BR Shooty, Shitty, Shit. E. Shit. E. BR. I like the guy, but I can't help being fun of him sometimes. Sad, man. For a legend, for a hero, for someone so high, lose everything. He's 80 years old. Just relax, keep a low profile, enjoy your retirement, stop all this nonsense. That's what I would tell him. Anyway, let me know your views in the comment section below. This is me signing off. You guys take care.